To battleground Canada now, the federal Liberal leadership race. Sun News reporter Jessica Murphy, she didn't waste her time on Saturday afternoon. It was valuable time to tell us all about what Liberals were chatting about. It wasn't really a debate, Jessica, joining us from our newsroom here in Ottawa, by the way. But what was going on? What happened on Saturday afternoon?
Well, it was a lot of talking, David. There was what the Liberals call it, a Davos-style debate, so one-on-one interviews with each of the nine candidates on stage. It was in Winnipeg, where the moderator, in this case, Harvey Locke, he ran for Calgary Centre in a by-election last year, would talk to the candidates in a bit of a get-to-know-you session and also talk about policy and the like. They had a few main topics of conversation. The Liberals had said beforehand, this was the style that they would have for one of the five upcoming debates. So here we saw them roll it out, and it's been getting mixed reviews. So if you were really looking for a lot of back and forth between candidates, a little bit of fireworks, that knockout debate punch, this was going to be disappointing for you. But if you wanted to get to know the candidates a little more, a little bit of their policies, this was your opportunity. Let's take a listen to Mark Garneau's answer in a bit of a get-to-know-you question, actually, on Saturday.
I'm going to be very personal here and tell you that I love to vacuum. There is nothing more satisfying than sucking up a dust buffalo with a vacuum cleaner. I've had many hours of enjoyment from doing it, although I have to admit I'm not very big on dusting. Although with the new Swifter glove that you can put on, you can do some pretty neat stuff.
So, well, there was a little bit of talk, David, about policy, a bit of a disagreement with supply on supply management and so on, dairy, poultry, the way, you know, that works with farms in Canada, between some candidates, some supporting and others against. That was really one of the most memorable moments, one of the most chatted about moments. So it gives you a bit of an idea. It was a lot lighter. All the candidates came out afterwards and discussed the merits of various chores. Who likes to cook? Who doesn't? Who's a fan of Swiffer? I saw jokes on Twitter about, you know, this debate is brought to you by Procter & Gamble, for example. So we'll have to see now how the other debates roll out, this one coming up in the GTA in a couple of weeks, and whether or not we'll see more debate again like we did in the first one between some of the candidates.
Now, I want to ask a little more seriously then about some of the things the candidates are doing to win caucus support. We talked to George Takacs on this program last week. He was suggesting caucus support is not that important, particularly with these supporter classes. But what are candidates doing to try and get the support of those Liberals already in the House of Commons?
Well, first off, I'll say that one candidate, and I think you can guess which one, has been getting a lot of support from his caucus colleagues. That is Justin Trudeau. He has been considered the front runner for a while now for a host of reasons, including he's ahead in fundraising. We can see some of the support that he has right there. There are 35 seats. The Liberals have 35 seats in the House of Commons. He has at least 11 of his caucus colleagues supporting him, including Ralph Goodale. He's the deputy party leader. Dominique Leblanc was one of the early people who people considered a leadership candidate. He actually came out supporting Justin Trudeau. I'll say John McCallum is also another MP who supports Justin Trudeau, who's not on the board. Mark Garneau, though, does have a few caucus colleagues supporting him as well. He has Ted Hsu, he has John McKay, and Jim Karagiannis, those two last ones, longtime MTs. Ted Hsu just winning in the 2011 election, taking Peter Milliken's seat in Kingston. But some of the candidates will also have a chance tonight to meet with all the caucus members. The Liberals are having a special caucus meeting tonight with six of the candidates. Martin Cochon, Deborah Coyne, Justin Trudeau, Mark Garneau will be there as well. Karen McCrimmon, Joyce Murray will all be there talking to their caucus colleagues, talking to caucus members and MPs. They will be asked, for example, about how, if they were leader, how they would work with caucus and what kind of relationship that would be, and on policy as well. So they do have a chance, another bit of a get-to-know-you session with the people they will possibly in the future be working with. And just to wrap up from there, most of the candidates are campaigning throughout Ontario for the rest of the week, whether it's here in Ottawa, Toronto, and the like.
All right, Jessica Murphy in our newsroom tonight with all you need to know about the Liberal leadership race. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, Sun Media National Affairs columnist Anthony Furey joins us now. I've got the big question for you. Are you in favor of vacuuming or against vacuuming?
Yeah, I love that that could be the question. You answer it right, bam, next prime minister.
Well, there
that's
was
quite easy job interview.
The funny thing was, I mean, because Garneau was first in that thing, and he said, I love vacuuming, and Martha Hall Finley right. came out as the I hate vacuuming candidate, so we see attention already on the
at
household chore
debate.
Issue.
At least there's debate on the issues. Yeah,
exactly. More seriously, you know, that format, whatever it is, they got asked sort of the same series of questions, some more important than others. What does this gang need to do to move the discussion forward, move the conversation with Canadians forward?
Well, I guess they first need to ask themselves a question. What are we watching here? Are mm-hmm. we watching the natural governing party mere moments away from resuming its place as heir to the throne, mm-hmm. becoming prime minister, bam, right away. Remember, we had that poll, one of those polls that said if Justin Trudeau ran tomorrow, he'd be made majority leader.
Right.
One of those crazy stats. Or is it the third party that actually has to work hard, grassroots, build itself up, and work to earn the respect of Canadians slowly over a long period of time? They need to answer that question first before they can really decide what sort of process they're in right now, and I don't think they have answered that question.
We just heard from Jessica that they're talking to caucus today, or some of them are talking to the caucus today, and of course, you should point out three are in that caucus, Joyce Murray, Mark Garneau, and Justin Trudeau. Is it important? Do you get the sense that caucus is going to be important? And we should also mention the senators as well are also part of the caucus. Because George Akacs was saying, you know, it's not the establishment's race here. It's for supporters. It's for other people. So who cares if I got an MP on my side?
Akacs is completely right. I mean, it helps when you do your photo ops for you to not be just one guy who nobody really knows who you are, surrounded by nobody. It helps mm-hmm. to be a guy who people know who you are, surrounded by familiar faces, but at the same time, I do think that the people already piling on to support Justin Trudeau do think that they're harkening back to the days of delegated conventions, and it's no surprise that Hedy Fry, Ralph Goodale, Dominic LeBlanc, people who are very used to that sort of game are doing what one would do in that game, but the rules have changed. So George Takacs is right, I think it helps to have caucus support, but yeah.
I would suggest that for Takacs, for David Burtsie, for McCrimmon, all these people who've never won an election, it's vital to have someone who's won an election standing by your side saying, not only did this guy win an election, he can lead us to victory. Less so important for Joyce Murray or Mark Garneau, but I would say very important if you've never won an election.
Yeah, I think Mark Garneau is a guy who many people could get behind, elect him leader. I mean, I think they'd be crazy to not elect him leader over Justin Trudeau, but you're totally right, people like Karen McCrimmon. Now, I remember in two Liberal leaderships ago, Martha Hall Findlay was seen as someone who's just running, so she'll have a higher profile for when she runs for MP, mm-hmm. and that worked. She won in Willowdale. She was the MP there after that. I don't get that sense with people like McCrimmon. I get the sense that they are actually out there and they do want to bring forward their ideas. So one would think that they would also be working to sort of broaden a nationwide base. Maybe they are, and then they haven't been too successful in that.
We in the media like to watch a good fist fight, but I'm going to suggest that if I'm one of these candidates, it is time to put up some dukes at some of the other candidates. That's the only way, particularly for the lower tier, the people not named Justin Trudeau, that they are going to be able to differentiate themselves to win the number two or three spots on the preferential ballot that Liberals will eventually cast.
And you and I have just finished a month of talking about the Ontario Liberal leadership race. Why are they not debating? Well, maybe it's because there's all these safety issues about the fact they're about to go to the polls. They might mm-hmm. completely lose. They don't want attention. But here, what's there to lose?
There's a long way to the next election.
There is nothing. Long way to the next election. And again, third party. I mean, there's only an upside here, people. So there's nothing wrong with taking a risk. And I think that's what we need to see here. We need to see some form of risk-taking, what direction they're going to go in. We need to see more left-leaning Liberals against more right-leaning. I mean, it's still a big tent party, mm-hmm. even though it's small in terms of numbers, still ideologically big tent. So craft that tent, folks.
And there's lots, you're right, there's lots and lots of people across the country who call themselves Liberals. They've only got at this point, roughly 100,000 sort of ready to vote. Are we going to take a look at this and have any metrics? Does it need to be as big as a Conservative convention, an NDP convention? You know, if you're stacking up against other parties, is there some metric at the end of all this? We will say, well, there we go. They're on the road up again.
Well, yeah, I think you want to have numbers that parallel those figures. I think the NDP convention last year had only about 60,000 people who actually voted.
And you had to be a paid-up member in that one.
Exactly. The supporter category, you might have a base 60,000 and an extra 40,000 supporters. Who knows? You get to your 100 grand, but you wonder how firm are these supporter categories. They're going to run quite a, I don't want to say a risk, but it's going to be interesting to see how the supporter category unfolds. I mean, you or I could just go on and toss our votes at anyone and throw the push the party in any tent direction that we want to go. We leave. We're no longer responsible for it, and they got to deal with the choices we've made.
There was one other little news release that came out today from a group called Fair Vote Canada. You probably heard of these folks. They want proportional representation. Get rid of the first past the post system. Joyce Murray is the only one really advocating this position. Is this perhaps a good time to talk about this? I don't know where you stand on PR, as they call it. You know, do we get rid of this system?
Yeah, the NDP talked about it every day until they got to the point when they were in opposition where, they stood maybe something to lose if they actually got that. So they haven't been talking
about
it too
much. And the Bloc Québécois got thumped, despite the fact they would have done well under a PR position.
So. Yeah, exactly. So you've always got to look at motives here. I really think there's arguments for and against and fair vote. I mean, if they're not happy with the direction Canada is going in, well, blame the process. Mm-hmm. That's generally my view, because there's pros and cons to all these setups. So one has to wonder, well, what's Joyce Murray's motive here? What does she stand to gain by a switch?
Yep, there you go. Anthony Furey, thank you so much.